Hello, my name is Eric Anscombe. I'm the managing attorney here at Intercontinental IP. We're a Carlsbad-based intellectual property law firm. One of the nicest parts of Borrego Springs is Fonts Point. You can drive out here. It's a 4-mile dirt road from the Salton Sea Highway, and you get a beautiful view of Fonts Point, which is sort of like San Diego County's version of the Badlands. As an inventor, there are a lot of cliffs you want to avoid falling off. Behind me is one at Fonts Point you probably wouldn't tumble down. But as an inventor, there are a number of other ones that you have to avoid as well. The next session of our educational series here is going to cover some of the pitfalls that inventors frequently face when they're trying to turn an invention from the conceptual stage to a product on the shelves. The first major problem that we see with a lot of inventors is they begin the invention process with inadequate capitalization. Basically, they don't have enough money to finish up the job they're starting. So, as a general rule, I think you should have between $5,000 and $10,000 that's set aside for your invention before you even consider trying to go through the patenting and prototype process. This is really the bare minimum that it's going to take to get you through these two sessions and get you in a position where you can visit a few trade shows, see some manufacturers, perhaps talk to some prospective licensees. If you don't have a prototype, then you don't know whether your product really works or not. And if you don't have at least some sort of patent pending status on it, it's awfully hard to sell it because basically an idea without any protection is not worth a whole lot. Another cliff you can fall off as an inventor are invention promotion companies. Now, why would anyone give thousands upon thousands of dollars to an organization or to a business that has less than 0.5% success rate? Well, I don't know that, and you shouldn't either, and yet every year thousands and thousands of people hire invention promotion companies to try to turn their ideas into profit. And because of this low success rate, it doesn't seem like a very good use of your money, and yet again, a lot of people do. Now, what can you do about it as an inventor? Well, first of all, you can understand your rights under the American Inventors Protection Act of 1999. Among your rights here is the right to ask any invention promotion company how many people they've taken money out of over the last few years, and of those people, how many made more money out of the efforts of the invention promotion company than they spent on paying the invention promotion company for its services. And when you compare those two numbers, you'll see that the success rate for most invention promotion companies is less than 0.5%. So, second cliff you can avoid falling off of.